So today is Taste of Thursday, and I'm Miss Rosie, and today is my day of cooking. And so today I'm gonna make some Jell-O, and I'm gonna use some different molds. So make sure you definitely check it out, and I hope you love it.
Hey, so this is Miss Rosie, and on our segment of Taste of Thursday, we are going to be making some Jell-O. So first, of course, I wash my hands because that's probably the best ideal and the most sanitized ideal is to wash your hands before you start cooking. So I've actually, personally, I've never made Jell-O before, but I thought it was really cool. And I was like, if you guys are gonna do it, I might as well do it with you. So I'm gonna read the box specifically on what I need to do. And it says, get 1 cup of boiling water. So instead of boiling the water on the stove, which is something that you guys can do, I'm just gonna go ahead and use my Keurig because it's hot boiling water. So I'm gonna lift to begin, press continue. A cup is converted to, I believe, 8 ounces. So I'm just gonna go ahead and let that go. And then it says get 1 cup of cold water. I'm gonna turn my sink on. Some cold water. So I'm just gonna go over to the sink. And I'm gonna grab a couple mixing bowls as well. And then I'm gonna turn this back over here so you guys can see what I'm doing. And now it says add boiling water to gelatin mix and stirring for 2 minutes. So I'm gonna go ahead and open this. Go ahead and put this in my bowl, which I got my Jell-O from Walmart. It was probably one of the cheapest snacks I think I make is Jell-O. Trash over here, so got my hot water. Make sure you're careful with your hot water that you don't burn yourself. Got my cold water. Couldn't find which side of the box to read. It says add boiling water to gelatin mix, stir for 2 minutes until completely dissolved, and then stir in the cold water. I feel like I might need a bigger bowl. So I'm just gonna go under here, grab one of my Tupperware bowls, and try this bowl. Looks a little bigger. I'm gonna add my boiling hot water. Dissolved by now. I don't see any more particles from the powder. It looks like it's completely dissolved. I'm just gonna stir a little more just in case it's not. Never hurts to be cautious. Stirring. It looks like it's completely dissolved for sure. Now I take my 1 cup of cold water and I go ahead and pour it into my bowl. did something a little different. I have these cool little molds, which are really just ice cube trays. You can use cups, you can use all types of different things. I just wanted to get use out of these things, so I'm just gonna go ahead and spill it into here. I spilled a little, which is okay. And then after that, you're gonna go ahead. Well, I got a little bit left, so I'm gonna spill it into my next mold. It's not gonna fill it up completely, but it'll fill it up a little bit. And then after that, it looks like you're supposed to go ahead and set this into the refrigerator. So I'm gonna go ahead and set it into the refrigerator and wait for it to firm. Wait for it to get firm, and then I'll come back out. Okay, so that is exactly how you make Jell-O, and then maybe I will take a picture or do another video on what the Jell-O comes out to and what it looks like. So make sure you check out Cyber Club and check out the rest of the stuff that's going on, and I hope you love it.